pertinent issue before this honorable court is the custody of the child to his mother will not be detrimental to his physical and mental welfare, and that the financial condition of the mother will not be taken into consideration while giving away the custody of the minor child. The counsel humbly submits before this honorable court that the custody of the child to his mother will not be detrimental to his physical and mental welfare. Section 17 of the Guardians and Wards Act 1890 provides matter to be considered by the court in appointing a guardian. Subsection 1 of Section 17 of the Guardians and Wards Act 1890 states that in appointing or declaring the guardian of a minor, the court shall subject to the provisions of this section and be guided by what consistently with the law to which the minor in subject appears in the circumstances to be for the welfare of the child. Subsection 5 of Section 17 of Guardians and Wards Act 1890 states that the court shall not appoint or declare any person to be guardian against his will. Thus, the consideration of the court in relation to the above section is of immense importance in dealing with the welfare of the child. Your Lordship, moreover, in Section 13 of the Hindu Minority and Guardianship Act 1956 states that the welfare of the minor to be paramount consideration. Your Lordship, in Hoshi Doli Kuka versus Hoshiam Savaksha Doli Kuka, where the Honorable Supreme Court held that the principles of law in relation to the custody of a minor appears to be well established, it is well settled that any matter concerning a minor has to be considered and decided only from the point of view of the welfare and the interest of the minor. Your Lordship, further in Srimati Mohini versus Virendra Kumar, the Honorable Supreme Court held that the welfare of the minor is a supreme consideration of the court, where the decree of the divorce has been passed between the husband and the wife, the interest and welfare of the child is utmost important for the court. Thus, the court found it desirable to keep the child in the custody of the mother, and the court insisted for the welfare of the minor through and through. Therefore, bearing all these principles in mind, we can say the overall welfare of the minor can be attained if he remains in the custody of the mother. If your lordships are satisfied with issue number 3, the council seeks permission to proceed with issue number 4. Much obliged, your lordship. Your Lordship, the fourth pertinent issue before this honorable court is that the act of the husband actually amounts to cruelty. The counsel humbly submits before the honorable court that the act of the husband actually amounts to cruelty. Your Lordship, in Saptami versus Jagdish, it was held that if a spouse is subjected to false accusation of adultery, insults, humiliation, abuse and false charges of immorality, it would make married life impossible to be endured and would make a very unhappy and miserable existence. This type of cruelty is worse than the act of physical cruelty.
Counsel, how do you prove that the petitioner is false?
Though he was not present in, practitioner was not present with in India, he was in America. So from there, he cannot put some allegations. This is mere allegation. He was not with her. If your lordship is satisfied with the answer, the counsel seeks permission. Your Lordship, in this instant matter, the same has happened. The petitioner has falsely accused respondent for having illicit relationship with his which has devastated the respondent mentally and emotionally. Your Lordship, Section 13, Subsection 1, Clause 1A of the Hindu Marriage Act 1955 recognizes cruelty as a ground for dissolution of marriage. Your Lordship, as the petitioner claimed, the act of cruelty when mere reaction or exaggeration of so-called ill behavior, but in case of mental cruelty, there remains no direct evidence to prove the same. Your Lordship, the counsel seeks permission to draw the attention of the court towards the written submission of the page number 5, paragraph number 21, where in the case of A. Jayachandra versus Anil Kumar, it was held that legal cruelty has to be found not merely as a matter of a fact, but as the effect on the mind of the complainant spouse, because of the acts of the other. Where there is no direct evidence, courts are required to probe into the mental process and the mental effects of incidents that brought out in evidence. Your Lordship, in Shobha Rani versus Madhukar Reddy, the Honorable Supreme Court stated that the absence of intention would not make any difference if the facts, if the act complained of otherwise be considered be as cruelty in ordinary sense of human affairs. In this instant matter, the petitioner intention and act both clearly indicate towards repetitive act of mental cruelty. Your Lordship, in this instant matter, the petitioner's conduct has been repeatedly violent and causing immense mental wear and tear to the respondent. Therefore, the marriage can no longer sustain, as the ground of cruelty should be upheld as a valid legal ground for divorce. If your Lordships are satisfied with issue number 3 and issue number 4, the counsel seeks permission to proceed with the prayer.
From your part itself, as we have already said about the divorce, ground for divorce, ground for judicial separation.
Yes.
So according to what is the difference between the judicial separation and divorce?
Your Lordship, in judicial separation, the parties, they are permitted to live separately, but there are some rights and duties that bound into them, but and they cannot remarry. But 6 months, Your Lordship.
In this case, the instant case, what are the judicial separation given before the
No, Your Lordship.
Then how can the divorce directly can be given to the female person without any judicial separation?
There is a mandatory provision that before granting the divorce, the court should give the chance for judicial separation. At least for the six months. How do you argue?
Due to cruelties, Your Lordship. On the basis of cruelty, the respondent has filed in a petition for divorce and the Honorable Court has granted the divorce.
So according to you, if the case is on file on the ground of cruelty, then there will be no judicial separation and the court can directly give judgment for the divorce.
The respondent was not present during the petitioner was not present during the trial. So ex parte decree was granted. If your Lordship is satisfied with the answer, the counsel seeks permission to proceed with.
What is the minimum time period for under the Hindu law to file a petition for divorce, and whether the party is in the instant case or will be in the same regime?
Your Lordship, the minimum time period is 1 year. After the completion of 1 year, the parties can file a petition for divorce, and thus in this instant matter, the parties have completed more than 1 year. If your ladyship is satisfied with the answer, the counsel seeks permission to proceed with prayer. Much obliged, your ladyship. Wherefore, it is prayer, in light of the issues, raised arguments, advanced in authorities cited, that this Honorable High Court may be placed to adjudge and declare that the appeal filed by the petitioner is not maintainable. The decision of the subordinate court dismissing the petition for restitution of conjugal rights is valid. The act of the petitioner amounts to cruelty towards the respondent. The custody of the child should be sustained with the respondent and or pass any other order it may deem fit in the interest of justice, equity and good conscience. For this act of kindness, the petitioner, as in duty bound, shall ever pray. It was a pleasure arguing before this Honorable Court. Much obliged, Your Lordship.